Hi, I'm Kim, and you're watching Kim Wilson TV. My channel is dedicated to helping victims of narcissistic abuse get free and stay free. Now, many times we've talked about the common threads that will link the cluster Bs, the gaslighting, the projection, the lying, the cheating, you know, those crazy things they say and do. Definitely, there's a lot of anomalies that make them very unique. One is the smear campaign. Absolutely deplorable, vile, disgusting behavior. But again, absolutely synonymous with them. In fact, there is no other sector of the human population that will launch a smear campaign. So if you've been wondering if that smear campaigning asshole that you're with is a narcissist, if they're launching a smear campaign, they most certainly are, because no one else would lower themselves to that type of behavior. And in fact, there is quite a bit of evidence to support that. Now, what is a smear campaign? It's an absolutely vicious verbal assault. Always remember, they are liars first and foremost, habitual, chronic, pathological liars. And this gives them a chance to really shine as a liar. So this is a tactic that they love very much. Now, what's causing the smear campaign? Narc injury. It could be something very small. You could send them a private letter that, you know, threatens their frail ego. You could not want to go to the same restaurant that they want to go to. And that will be an absolute attack on their frail egos. You could be dumping them, you know, once and for all. So it can be something really, really minor or something really big. Either way, once the narc injury is inflicted, they go into a absolute fight to the death with themselves. Of course, no one's engaging them, but they're in a fight to the death because narc injury causes in them this incredible, overwhelming, obsessive, compulsive feeling in their delusion that they are being annihilated. It actually becomes a self-preservation moment for them where they will stop at nothing to kill you in their delusion, believing you are trying to kill them. I know, because you sent them a private note. Crazy. But again, regardless of what triggers the narc injury, I mean, you're dealing with such a disassociated person, with someone so disconnected from human reality. They are delusional, they are paranoid, they are frail, they are shame-based. I mean, you're dealing with a creature that just doesn't fit the realm of normal humanity. So this injury to them, even though it's something really small, is very real. It's very frightening to them. They become absolutely obsessed and consumed by this mortal wound. They have to lash out to actually try to kill you before you kill them. Now, of course, you're sitting at home watching a movie, feed up, having a glass of wine. You're not engaged, of course, but to them, this is real, and this is something that is active in them. It's something that's been triggered, that has them absolutely in full bleh, absolute puking up the most disgusting things. Now, again, this is very, very unique to them, very much like gaslighting and a discard. I mean, there's only a certain group of people capable of behavior that's absolutely fucking disgusting. And that's why, you know, you got to take it for what it is. This is a product of absolute delusion, paranoia, it being executed by someone who is barely human. So don't engage. Just don't engage. And yes, they are going to say some crazy, crazy shit. And the more you ignore them, the crazier it gets. But this is not your fucking problem. Actually, what's happening here is very largely they're confessing to their own horrible misdeeds. Secondly, if you give them enough rope, they will absolutely hang themselves and expose themselves completely. The more you ignore them, the more they feel they're being attacked. So you can actually sit back and have a good giggle about that, because they're absolutely shitting the bed. And you cannot engage them anyways. You got to consider these things have no limits, no boundaries. They will stop at nothing to inflict injury, believing they're going to get supply from that. When they don't injure you, all they've done is humiliate themselves. That's all they've done. It becomes a brunt of a joke. So if you could just sit back, be patient, and know you're dealing with someone who is absolutely disassociated from any type of real human connection. You're dealing with someone who is gravely ill, delusional, paranoid, fucked in the head in every way imaginable, and they're habitual liars. So everybody figures that out in time. Now, it can be a bit unsettling if it's the first time it happens to you and your instinct may be to lash back at them. You can never get that deep in the gutter. You cannot. How are you going to fight them on a level playing field? You're way up here. They're way down in the gutter. You won't stand a snowflake's chance in hell. So you got to let that idea go because it's not going to work. Period. Now, taking the high road, yeah, okay, we've done that lots. I fucking hear you. Every day I took the high road. Well, you know what? We need to take the high road here too. Because, first of all, they're nuts. Second of all, you do not lack integrity the way they do to get into the gutter like that. They have no shame, no remorse. There's no level of humiliation that they're not willing to inflict on themselves in a desperate attempt for supply. They're clawing. They're desperate now. They believe they've lost control of you, and all they can do to control this situation is to try and control how people perceive you. It's insanity, and they all do it. They're the only ones that do it. There's nothing more here than absolute more narc abuse and bullshit. So if you can detach from it and just watch it, I'm telling you, it can be quite amusing at times. Sad and amusing at times. You would think that every now and then, because, you know, these cluster Bs are in constant conflict. I mean, constant. They'll go from conflict to conflict to conflict their entire lives. And you would think in time, they would look up from the shit pile that is their life and say, wait a minute here. No one else is doing this. This is very weird behavior. Why am I doing this? No. They can justify it. Absolutely justify it. And initially, you're going to find as you ignore them, they see that as a huge attack on them because that just cut all that supply they need. Remember, you're dealing with a junkie here and the supply is their drug and they will become ravenous, dangerous, absolutely criminally slanderous and harassing to try and get it. But you know what? The thing about the smear campaign and what they love so much about it, of course, is that honing of their lying skills and that storytelling and all that absolute fantasy and delusion. And it wears thin on normal people real fast, real fast. I mean, people listen to it once, they hear it twice. Come on, you guys know that this isn't going to fly. Always take the high road in this case. Do not engage them. You're not equipped to fight them. And honestly, they will expose themselves. Besides, if anyone was to believe any of that shit, it's coming out of their mouth, you don't need them in your fucking life anyways. You know what? There's probably something wrong with them too. And always remember, they're constantly trying to recruit flying monkeys. So be careful who you're talking to. You know, if you're in a smear campaign, they are pack animals and they will immediately try to, you know, get themselves some flying monkeys to help with their dirty work and to do their dirty work for them. Ultimately, they're cowards and pieces of shit. So, yeah, this time too, guys. Sorry, I wish there was another answer, but we got to take the high road. Stay up here. Leave them down there in the gutter and pour yourself a glass of wine. I'm Kim. You're watching Kim Wilson TV. I hope you guys are having a great narc-free day. Peace be with you.